Blue Space. I'm coming to you today with a 30-minute, 30-day beginner yoga series. So we will go gentle, take it at your own pace, and just slowly start to learn and connect with our bodies and find a little more space, a little more breath, a little more peace, hopefully. So if a seated cross-legged position is too much for you this morning, feel free to open it up a little looser. Feel free to even come out of it completely and straighten out the legs if you need to. Just respect the low back, respect the body, find your own comfortable space. This morning we're simply going to start by breathing. Right? Our breath connects to our parasympathetic nervous system. All that fanciness really means is that your breath controls your mind, controls your body. You can literally exhale and release tension. So if you'd like, take your hand over your heart, take your hand over your belly, just so we can feel each breath rising and falling. If you want to close your eyes, close your eyes. If you feel comfortable with them open, that works too. But simply finding an inhale and an exhale. Let's stay focused with the breath through the nose for now. Seeing how long you can take that inhale. So let's say it's to a count of four. Inhale. And exhale. With each breath, seeing if you can deepen that space, that length a little longer. If we're inhaling to four, let's see if we can exhale to a five or a six. We have stale old air that kind of sits around in our lungs. We're always focused on that inhale, on that next breath, on where we're going, what we're doing, right, in this scattered, busy world that we live in. So see if we can slow it down. Inhale, two, three. And maybe try that exhale. If you've got a longer breath in control, take it longer. If you need it a little bit less, work through that. Find your own breath this morning. Continuing through our breath, maybe finding a little pause at the top. So inhaling to four. And exhale, stay with that five or six. Hopefully our arms starting to slowly find a little bit more peace, a little more relaxation, and a little more space in the body. When you're ready, inhaling the arms up. And exhale, releasing to one side. Again, feel free to keep the eyes closed. Maybe open them, whatever feels comfortable to you this morning. Or this evening. Or whenever you log in and find this video, indulge. Exhale for now. Finding your own back and forth, reaching to one side and to the other. Maybe taking it a little deeper with each reach. Maybe taking a little milder, right? If you need to, if that doesn't feel right, maybe just simply want to. Slightly fold it up. Inhaling through center, we're going to twist to the side. So take the left hand to the right knee. Sweep that right hand around. Use it to sit up tall. And then finish up your twist. Feel free to grab a book or a block or anything if you'd like. place it right underneath the right hand to help you sit up a little taller. Make sure that we lengthen the spine, each little space between the vertebrae, before we twist. Inhale, reach. And exhale, twist. Again, at your own pace, lingering anywhere that feels right for as long as you like, reach and twist. And twist. Slowly, releasing to center. And then we'll go into a nice deep breath. I'm going to turn around so you can see what's happening with my arms from behind. And I'm also going to grab a strap to show you guys that there are ways to find modifications for every space that we are in. So, again, find a comfortable seated position, whatever that may look like for you. Let's go ahead and take the strap. It can be a towel or anything else if you like. But if you have a strap, bring it over the left shoulder, down towards the right hip. Inhale, reach those arms back up. Exhale, take this left hand down. See if you can find the top of the strap. Grab the left elbow with the right hand and give it a little pull. Starting to open through the tricep and the lat. Excuse me. Good. Flip this right hand around. Find the base of your strap. So now it's here, and this is maybe where it stays today. This may be where it stays for weeks or months, right? But if you feel ready, you can start to walk the hands in towards one another, searching for the bind. And the bind is simply maybe a space where we eventually find hand to hand. Not the goal, right? Your body, your space, that's the goal. Listen to your shoulders. Maybe take the gaze out over the right shoulder. Come back to center. Maybe take a little fold to your right. Always listening to the neck. And following the gaze where that goes right through the cervical. Slide that strap over. Take it over the right shoulder and down towards the left hip. Inhale, reach. And exhale, drop that right hand. Again, when ready, sweep the left arm. Slowly find the base of the strap, right? Whatever it may look like for you this morning. And slowly slide it together. Again, the goal is not to look like me, but to find your own individual space. Slide the gaze over the left shoulder. Back to center and fold if you like. Lots of maybes, lots of choices in order. And slowly release. Let that strap go for now. Simply roll the shoulders out one way and the other way. Good. Take the hands, sweep them around behind, interlace, and walk them down. Take that nice deep breath. Inhale, open up the ribcage. And if you like, kind of squeeze the shoulder blades back. Maybe take the gaze up. And slowly let it go. I'm going to take the left arm over the body, cross it, pull the right hand, and then take your gaze back out over the left shoulder. So here, and cross it the other way. And slowly release. Take the palms out to your side, nice and wide. Imagine pressing the palms into the wall, right on either side, bringing the fingertips up as high as you can. Take an inhale. And exhale, release. we're going to massage that median nerve. We're going to take fingertips towards the shoulder blades. Then we're going to wing it back out. Again, in, and out. Staying connected with that breath as we move. Circle out the wrists. Other way. And slowly release. Take the right ear to the right shoulder. Sweep it around, chin to chest. Left ear, left shoulder. And now just find it back and forth, lingering anywhere that feels right to you. Coming back up to neutral. Are you ready? Take the hand, take the fingertips, pull the fingertips back, straighten the arms out all the way. So finding that stretch at the back of the arm. Then maybe work through one finger at a time. All the computer work, the desk work, the iPhones, the iPads, right? They're really starting to affect our forearms, our neck and shoulders, causing all kinds of grief. When you get to the thumb, kind of grab it, twist it, and pull it back. When you're done, maybe open and close, shake, circle, which is slowly released. Take the other hand, flip it over. Again, staying focused on that breath. The asana itself, the movement, the physical practice, obviously highly important. But that emotional, physical, mental well-being, connecting with the space, with the breath. Stop breathing. Stop yoga. So many benefits to conscious breathing. And again, maybe open, close, circle, shake, whatever you want. If you feel ready, we're going to slowly start to move our way into what's called table. Feel free to grab a pillow, a blanket, or anything if you have any knee issues and need to put a little extra padding underneath the knees. Slowly just roll yourself up. We're going to take the hands directly below the shoulders and the knees directly below the hips. When we press the hands into the earth, we spread the fingertips wide. We press the whole palm into the mat. We spend some extra time on our hands in yoga, so we need to find that space to protect our wrists. We're going to find what's called cat-cow. So arching, looking up. Exhale, tucking the chin, rounding the spine. Find our youth inside each space between the vertebrae, that flexibility of the spine. Again, your own breath, your own movement. Coming back to neutral. We're going to inhale the right arm up high. And we're going to exhale. We're going to sweep it all the way through. You can extend the left arm. You can extend the left leg. Just find that variation that finds the space on the back of the right shoulder. Inhale, reach. And exhale to table. Again, maybe another little cat-cow if you like. Maybe a little shake side to side. I'm going to turn this music up just a little bit for you guys this morning. Coming back into our table. Inhale, reach. Left arm sweeps. Inhale the left arm all the way back up. And exhale, release it back to table. Find a little side to side this time. So kind of head to hip. head to hip, opening through the obliques a little more, down the side of the body. Good. We're going to walk the hands forward, leave the knees right over the hips, and melt the heart to the earth. Sweep the hands to the left. Excuse me, sink the hips to the right. And if you like, take your gaze under the left arm. And sweep it across the other way. Hands to the right, hips to the left. And take your gaze under the right arm. Bring it back to center. Now we're going to flip the hands over. We're going to take the knuckles in towards one another. We're going to take the tops of the hands to the earth. We're searching for a stretch now on the opposite side of the arm. You're pushing the knuckles together, and you're pushing the hands down into the earth. Beautiful. Slowly release. Again, maybe shake, circle. Respect those wrists. We're going to go into what's called down dog. If down dog is too much for you this morning, go back into that happy puppy. Melt the chest to the earth and sink the knees right below the hips. Right? If you feel ready, again, check in with those hands. Press the palms into the earth. Spread the fingertips wide. We're going to curl the toes under. First, we're just going to sit back into the feet. Start to open up the arches of the feet. Maybe give a little shake side to side. Slowly just finding that space underneath the feet. And we're going to migrate into our down dog. So we're going to tuck the chin and the chest. And we're going to slowly start to lift the hips. Keeping in mind that the goal is not necessarily to straighten out the legs, but to find some space pressing the chest back towards the thighs. Tucking the chin into the chest, maybe shaking the head no. Again, remember, if this is too much for you this morning, go back to that happy puppy. Maybe walking out your dog, so pressing one heel, pressing the other, just kind of pedaling back and forth. Maybe taking your feet a little wider or a little narrower. Just listening to your body. Breathing through. Good. We're going to take the gaze forward towards the thumbs. We're going to lock the feet to the hands. So if you need to, bend the knees, take your time, or shimmy your body forward. When we come into our forward fold, we put a slight bend in those knees. We tuck the chin into the chest, and we fold it forward, letting it hang. If we need to, again, we find a block or a book or a pillow or anything to place underneath the hands. No pain in the low back, no pain in the neck. As we inhale, flat back, we press the hands maybe to the shins, maybe even to the thighs. We squeeze the shoulder blades together, and we come out with a nice flat back. Exhale, fold it back to the earth. And we'll do that again. Inhale, flat back. Exhale, fold. One more. Bend the knees generously, take the hands to the thighs, and slowly roll it all the way up. Head comes up last. Shoulders roll down and around. We're going to talk about Tadasana or Mountain Pose. Simply standing with correct posture, right? So many of us are here, we're there, we're never really like focused on just standing upright. So pressing the feet into the earth, the whole foot, right? If you pronate one way or the other, just look at the bottoms of your shoes and you'll find out which way that is. And I kind of focus on pressing the opposite way. So I slightly need to press in, kind of turn my thighs, pull up through the quads, squeeze the belly, squeeze the glutes, but relax the shoulders. Take a nice deep breath in here. And I will turn this way, and that way, and this way, all throughout the practice. Don't feel like you necessarily have to follow with me. Just stay where you feel comfortable throughout your movement. I try and just give you different perspectives on my body so that you can see what's going on and hopefully follow along with that proper form in your home, all right? So we're about halfway through this morning or this evening, morning for me if you guys are at home, evening class. So just take a little breath, shake it out. We're gonna do a full flow here. We're gonna do a little modified variation of that flow. So we're gonna find the top of your mat. You're gonna inhale, reach it back up. Exhale, fold it all the way down. Again, bend the knees, chin tucks into the chest. Inhale, flat back. Support yourself wherever you need. A block, the shins, remember even the thighs. Exhale, press the hands into the earth. Step, hop, or walk back to plank. So take a look at those hands, press them all the way into the mat. Your plank can be here, your plank can be here. Heck, if you're struggling this morning, maybe some shoulder problems, your plank can even be here, okay? So your body, your plank, find your own space. We're gonna lower all the way to the belly. So drop the knees maybe, release the body to the earth. We're gonna come into our cobra. So we're gonna lift the chest off the mat just slightly. We're not pressing way up yet here. The elbows are squeezed together. Shoulder blades are wrapped around the side. The chest is lifted. We're pressing the hands in through the earth. And we take a breath. Toes together, knees up wide. We'll go back to what's called child's pose. Press it back. Reach those fingertips as far forward as you can. And we'll come back into our table. We'll walk the hands back towards the butt. Maybe take that little cat-cow, a little shake, a little breath, whatever you need. Good. We're going to take this right arm, we're going to extend it just straight out to the side here. We're going to drop it to the earth, and then we're going to turn the body towards the left. So you're opening through the chest and the shoulder on the right side. Go back to table. Again, extend the left arm straight out, drop the hand down to the earth. You can kind of flip the hand over, press it to the earth, and then start to twist towards the right. Coming back to center, back to take. Take a breath here. Turning it around, bring it forward, and we're going to sink into this right hip flexor, opening up that space. If you sit at a desk all day, this area will be very tight. So slowly sink it in. Check that left knee. It is right over the left ankle, keeping this knee safe while we open up the hip flexor. Feel free to just stay right here if this is what's working for you. If you want to take it a little further, you can come up, you can find balance. You can have a block on either side to help balance you as well. If you want to challenge a little more this morning, inhale the arms overhead. Maybe slide it back just a bit. Good. We're going to release. We're going to take the left hand to the left hip. Inhale that right arm and fold over to the side. You can release to the earth or maybe hand to the block. Or leave it right there at the hip. Good. Bring it back to center. And we're going to straighten out the front leg, opening the hamstring, the calf, and pulling it forward. You can point the toes, you can flex the toes. It will change the stretch. Again, where's your breath? back to center. And then we'll slide that left knee back to meet the right. Again, taking that little back out or side to side, or even a full circle, whatever it is. Just resetting with the spine, checking back in with your body. We're going to move on to that right side, so simply bringing the right foot forward and sinking it in. I say simply, sometimes it's easier said than done, right? So listen to your body. If it's difficult, find a new variation, a new twist, a new way to get there. You don't have to follow me exactly. Listen to what your body is telling you. So again, the right knee is now over the right ankle. We're opening through the left hip flexor. We take a couple breaths here. And if we'd like to take it further, we walk it up, we find our balance, we inhale the arms, we maybe fold. Good. We'll take that right hand to the right hip, inhale the left arm, fold it to the side. Take this right foot, pull it into the left thigh. Again, think about your length, reach, and fold. Use that strap. Inhale, fold it forward. Inhale. Just listen to your body. Slowly bring it back up. I'm going to turn to the side here so you can see. Leave the left hand wherever it was. Take the right arm back, open it up, take a gaze at that right arm, and then we fold over the side. Maybe the arm goes straight up. Maybe it starts to come forward. Maybe it searches through those toes. But again, this is beginner yoga. So listen. Find the length across the side body. Beautiful. Roll it up. And switch it out. Straighten out the right leg. Pull in the left. Take the left foot to the inner right thigh. Sit up tall. Maybe grab your strap. But reach and fold. Good. Again, leaving the right hand wherever it may hit. Maybe it's at the knee or anywhere down towards the toe. Reach the left arm back. Take a glance at that left hand back there. And we'll take it back over the side. The soles of the feet together if you need to. We take them way out, or we can pull them in anywhere you like. Maybe let the feet kind of sway open like a book, helping the knees kind of open, the inner thighs open a bit. Let's take the hands behind the body, kind of lift and shake, opening those hips a little bit more. Sometimes they kind of catch. That'll help release that catch. Take an inhale, sit tall, and an exhale, fold forward. Slowly release. Roll up. Assist the knees back together. Slide the hands underneath, hand to wrist or hand to elbow. Tuck the chin into the chest, round through the spine. And slowly release. Find the center of your mat. We're going to go ahead and roll it all the way down. If you need to, support yourself with your hands as you roll back, or if you like, pull the knees into the chest, pull through the core, and release to the earth. Take a little rock side to side, massaging the low back. Open the arms out to a T, press the palms down towards the earth. Bring the knees to a 90-degree bend. And slowly sweep them over your left-hand side. You need to loosen that up a bit, release them down. You need to pull it in a little tighter, pull the knees towards the chest. There. If you like, you can straighten all the leg. You can even take the gaze over the right shoulder. And we'll sweep it all the way across from the knees. And take it over. Again, breathe. Shoulders stay in contact with the earth no matter how far the knees go. So if you need to slide a block or a pillow underneath the knees for support, feel free. Straighten out the legs if you like and take that gaze over the left shoulder. Bend the knees, slowly bring it back to center. Take one more little rock side to side. Find that blood flow release. And then go back. Release the heels to the earth. We're going to come into bridge, our final pose today. Take your hands by your side. Space between the chin and chest. Maintain that space, protecting the cervical. When we lift, we squeeze the glutes. We pull in the belly and you lift. If you like, you can take and just leave the hands at the side. Or you can interlace them behind and roll up on the shoulders. Beautiful, slowly release. We're going to make our way into Shavasana, aka lay down. We're going to slide the legs out. Release the arms by your side. Shake the head no. But what you're looking for is a comfortable position. So if the low back is strained, maybe bend the knees. If we need support underneath the head, maybe grab a blanket and a pillow. But all I want you to do here is breathe. Let it go. Maybe stay focused on that long, conscious breath. Or maybe simply allow the breath to return to you. Sometimes be the most difficult part of our practice. along with our thoughts. So feel the stillness and quiet and space. Staying here in your shavasana, breathing, focusing on your body, your mental awareness,
say bye. Say namaste. Good job.